So, Professor Sinha, thank you very much for delivering the very first inaugural Dr. Samuel Paul Memorial Lecture. You held the audience spellbound, but two important questions that you raised is something that I would like to talk about. First is, you pointed to the fact that enabling children to achieve their full capability is not something that can be done overnight, and that it entails resolving conflicts. Can you just elaborate a little bit on that?
I said it in the context that usually when talks about children, one talks about them as if they're poor things and we have to give them some help. But it's just not enough to think about it as poor things. We have to find out, why is it that we are not able to reach out to them? What is stopping anything coming in the, what is coming in the way? And then you find that there are some hidden power structures that come in the way of a simple thing like a food to the child, you know, and these will have to be resolved. Say for example, as I told you about even the breastfeeding, you know, unless a woman is given the time and leisure to feed the child, you will not be able to ask her to do breastfeeding. And soon after her delivery, within a week's time, she has to go back to work. And she can't even carry her child. And we know in many communities, they leave behind the child in the hut and they're compulsorily going off to work. So how is it that we will have to get the entire family to support her and the child, at least for that time period? And what is it that you're resolving in that space? It also requires, of course, state support. You know, there is now, maternity benefit and 6,000 rupees that come, but does it reach? In some states, there are good governance, in some states, it just doesn't reach. So we will have to see how it can happen.
What would your advice be, ma'am, for an organization like Public Affairs Center? Moving forward, we would like to focus on some work at the ground level on children.
I think that's a very difficult thing to answer, but since you are talking about governance, and there are not enough studies about governance, you know, the governance in the sense, say for example, when you're talking about a school and education, you're constantly blaming the teacher for not teaching. But what is the structure in the education department that allows a teacher to teach? What is the role of the cluster resource organizer? What is the role of the block education officer? What is the role of DEO? Can we do some time and motion study on how much time they actually spend on giving quality of education? You know, for example, when we did a very small study, we are just activist group, we found that most of the education department was spending time, this was about 15 years ago, on giving recognition to private schools or on teacher transfer. And what they did diligently was to conduct the board examination. These were the three tasks only that they did, you know, or data collection. But where did they have children on the radar? So one will have to look at the governance structure, what support they give for the teacher to teach and for the child to learn. That I would be very happy to. Likewise in every other sector, you know, not look at the last leg. Not look at the Anganwadi center, teacher, worker, not look at the face that we are seeing, but all the invisible players, what are they doing and what is their role? That I would like to know and find out.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.